Well, every collector has his secret stash. Every collector and folks that are in the business, they also have new old stock parts, okay? And I'm looking at one right here. You know, Matt, this thing's still got the tag on it.
Oh, yeah.
But one of the unique things that you have here, tell me about what's in these crates.
These are actually new old stock M38 A1 fenders. It's a left and a right.
Wow.
And a lot of people don't realize that there's still a few out there. It's the right front fender that you can't find, because actually the government never requisitioned the right front fender as a spare part. So anytime you find a new old stock right front fender, it's normally M170. They did for the M170 ambulance, but for the 38A1, they didn't do it.
I'll be darned.
So they're extremely rare.
Wow.
And this one here is a new old stock right front fender. That's the one that everybody always hits and tears up.
Yeah, because the driver couldn't see when he
was turning. Exactly, and it's the early style with the leg that goes down. That's what you see on the 53, 52, 53, 54.
And you got them here at Quarter Ton Military Parts.
I got one or two. Yeah, they're kind of hard to find.
Okay, well, now I have to ask you now, this secret room that you guys always have. Everybody always has that secret room with the parts that nobody ever knows about.
Yeah, you caught me.
Okay, well, listen, folks, we're headed over to the secret room, okay? And you're going to get a military collector first right here at Quarter Ton Military Parts. Well, folks, I know this room in here doesn't look like much, okay, to a collector. This is where the secret stash is, okay? One of the most unique things that you've got in your secret part stash, okay? Because I mean, we're talking new old stock, steel, original packaging, and all that kind of thing.
Oh, yeah.
What would it be? What would it be, Matt?
I think the prize of my collection is a new old stock Ford steering wheel. I mean, it's still in the original box with the original label on it. But what's so unique about it, it's the early black one.
Oh,
you
wow.
It's a Scheller. You don't see the early black ones like that, especially in normal production. This is what you would have seen on the early script Fords.
Okay.
Some of the very first production Ford Jeeps that were, the first contract.
Right.
And so that kind of makes this the rare of the rare.
Is this the only one you have?
This is the only one I've got.
Got. What's that thing worth, roughly?
I sold some metal spoke new old stock ones I found years ago, and they went for $1,500 to $1,700.
Wow.
I really wouldn't even know where to price it. It'd probably bring 2,000 or something, but I mean, the thing that it's still in the box, it'd be almost be a shame to use it.
Exactly.
I mean,
yeah.
They just don't exist, and it's more of a museum piece than it would be on a Jeep.
Exactly. One other item, okay?
Oh, yeah. Hey, it's my favorite over here.
Oh, okay.
Good old greasy Cosmoline.
Well, listen, I don't want to.
Oh, yeah.
Let's
we'll cover that up.
Yeah. Yeah, I'll move this over here.
I found these at a surplus yard. This was kind of, I know it looks horrible, but it's a YS-637. It's early with the penny in the bowl. These are some of the rarest carburetors for the M38. That's the flat fender 24-volt Jeeps. We just a dumb discovery. We uncovered them, cleaning out a storage container. And the guy who had them he knew what they were. He actually stashed them away. Back in the very back corner of a cabinet. And they were rebuilt by the government, and then they were sprayed with Cosmoline and then covered up in this old greasy stuff.
Goodness.
But
those are worth what? $500-$600
Yeah, maybe? They're anywhere from $425 to $500.
Okay.
Yeah, there's a little bit of surface rust on it, but hey, it's 50, 60 years old.
Exactly.
And it's been in storage that long. But yeah, this is one of the rare carburetors that's really hard to find and very sought after by the purist when they're building the M38. Also got the newer style. This is the first style of the 637.
Wow. But, well, I tell you, Matt, this is impressive. And folks, listen, there's so many more things in his secret stash room. We just can't cover them all. But listen, if you'd like to talk parts, reach out to Matt Fox at Quarter Ton Military Parts, okay? Go to militarycollectorstv.com. His icon will be there. His emails, his phone numbers. This guy, if you are restoring a vehicle, this guy's probably got the parts to do it with right here, one of the largest in the country, maybe even one of the largest in the world, right down here in Chickamauga, Georgia.